Great actor Jonathan Pryce is here, and the Wayback Machine, Jonathan, because this was such a big deal at the time. Do you remember the Infinity commercials?
Yeah, I sure did. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you remember them?
Very grateful for that.
Because that was a hugely lucrative circumstance at the time, was it not?
It was, and I did it for 4 years. And
did they give you a lot of Infinities? There you are.
Oh, look. Oh, the poor guy. Look at that dark hair. Yeah.
But with something like that, I know they pay you in money, but do they pay you in cars as well?
There was a cut whenever I came to America, wherever I was, there would be an Infinity waiting.
Oh, very nice.
Nice. Yeah. Okay. Well, that's fantastic.
And then I stopped doing the commercials, and it was like, get out of here.
Don't even drive our car.
Welcome to show business.
We're done.
Game of Thrones has gotten an awful lot of attention, and you were saying, even though you've got this incredible body of work, that people mention it every time.
Every time, wherever I am. And there are fans everywhere in the world. And I was in China last year, got off a ferry boat to a small island in China, came down the gangplank. I won't do a corny Chinese accent.
Right.
I'll be in trouble.
Yes.
But it was High Sparrow, and he was coming down.
And when you were involved with it, was it big then, or sort of became?
It was huge. I had actually been asked to do the pilot, the very first series, and it's a genre of television filmmaking that I'm not attracted to, and I passed on it. I looked at the script and I thought, God, there's all these weird names and strange dialogue. But I passed. So I waited until it became a huge international hit, and then came in with High Sparrow, and I had the best time you could possibly have. Wonderful production team, and it was great. Yeah.
Big premiere last night. This new movie is called The Wife, opposite Glenn Close. And you know that I think of that Bette Midler song, "Wind Beneath the Wings." And is that effectively? It's much more dramatic than that, but.
But Wind Beneath, I'm not aware of that song.
Oh, where she is the person behind the man.
Oh, I see. Yeah, that's very much the theme of the film. Hmm.
That being that you play a character who wins a Nobel Prize.
Yeah, I'm a hugely successful author. Where I'm on my way, you see on the screen there, I'm being told that I've got the Nobel, and we head off to Stockholm to receive it. And it's ostensibly a story about an author who receives the Nobel. But essentially, it's a love story between two adults, two 70-year-olds, in a long relationship. Anything I say about this film is a spoiler.
Okay.
Because you have to. It all happens at the end. There's a big reveal, but on the way, it's a dissection of a relationship, and it was just wonderful working with Glenn. She is an extraordinary actress.
I don't think this will give too much away. It's from the trailer. This is a little bit look at the movie's called The Wife.
Don't paint me as a victim. I am much more interesting than that.
Now walk away from me, Diamond!
I can't do it anymore. I can't take it. I can't take the humiliation.
What are we doing?
Joan, we're not bad people.
I think you are sick and tired of Joe Castleman.
I would like to convey to you the warm congratulations of the Swedish Academy. You have reinvented the very nature of storytelling.
Tell me about yourself. Do you have an occupation?
I do.
And what is that?
I am a kingmaker.
I am a kingmaker.
Wow.
So you said, which I thought was very interesting, because often people will walk the red carpet and then not actually see the movie. You sat in the premiere last night.
I did. It's only the second time I've seen it. First time I saw it on a laptop that kept breaking down. And it's really great to watch that film with an audience. Mm. I mean, it's a kind of domestic tragedy, which people would think would be on TV or something, but it will divide the audience. Mm. And it's not just for women to go and see. Men will enjoy it. They'll be better people after seeing it,
oh.
I think. And it was great last night to hear the laughter and also to hear the extraordinary silence when
wow.
Things were getting hot.
There you've got it. The Wife will open in select theaters August 17th. When Netflix, The Pope comes out, you'll have to come back and talk to us about that.
Sure, and can I just say good morning to Christian Slater, who promised he'd get up to watch this interview.
So. Oh, really?
Thanks, Chris.
We're seeing Christian later today at the Junket, so we'll make sure that he saw it. Well,
very nice. That is.
Yeah. Now go back to bed.
Christian's now smiling ear to ear. Good to see you this morning.
Thank you, Jonathan.
Thank you so much.
Such a pleasure.